Okay, Master Gardeners, I get this question all the time. Why is my oak tree dying? And it's a characteristic that's occurring throughout the state of Maryland. Many oak trees with very large diameters are dying back now. We don't really know why. People are calling me saying, I think I have sudden oak death, and they're self-diagnosing, and that's not a situation. We're not finding sudden oak death is found in Maryland. It's not widely found, and we're even, some people are reporting that they think they have oak wilt. That's another disease that's not really been widely diagnosed here in the state of Maryland. I'm standing under a particular tree that is an oak tree. It's in the red-black group, and this one's dying. The MDA has been monitoring many trees throughout the state of Maryland to try to determine why they're dying. This one was looked at and researched through MDA, and they diagnosed it as having bacterial leaf scorch. MDA has been studying many trees, and they've been finding the two-line chestnut borer. They've been finding oak anthracnose is one of the common problems, and bacterial leaf scorch is one of them. Bacterial leaf scorch is a disease that you typically see in the late summer or fall, which is what this one is showing, a little bit of symptoms. Not too many leaves even left on this tree. Oftentimes with bacterial leaf scorch, the leaves will cling on, but this tree is not super advanced, I guess. But when you get bacterial leaf scorch, scorching is scorching. It's this bronzing color on the outer margins of your leaf. That would be what the symptoms look like. This disease is spread by little insects, and the little insects have dirty mouth parts, and when they're feeding on your trees, they're sucking juice, but their mouth parts are diseased and dirty. Whatever part of the tree they feed on, that disease, it's a bacteria, is absorbed and carried into the tissue, and it clogs the veins inside the tree. It tends to be scattered symptoms throughout the tree. Some of the diseases that are occurring occur from the top down, and some diseases occur from the bottom up. This one occurs throughout the whole tree. So those are all different symptoms that you would need to look and diagnose on your particular oak tree if it's dying. Another big problem is oftentimes there's borer insects. I inspected this tree bark really close. Look over here. If you were searching for borer drill holes, you would look for little holes that were the size of a pencil lead drilled in here. And sometimes they're D shapes, but you'd look in and out of the fissures of the bark to try to find spots where there are borers. If a tree has got borers on it, that indicates the tree was probably already under stress from something else, because usually borers are considered secondary problems. So any kind of environmental stresses can invite these kind of diseases to come on your trees. So make sure you're doing safe precautions. You're not running weed whackers around the base of your tree. You're not excavating a new driveway. You're not driving heavy equipment over top of areas around your tree. If you're fertilizing your lawn once a year in the fall, that could be helpful for a tree. You know, that food is going into its root system as well. Make sure you're not changing the grade. Don't think, oh, I got some surface roots, I'm going to add topsoil. That's a no-no, because those are all stressors for your tree. So if you have oak trees, these diseases affect both the red and the black cultivars, and even some of the white oaks have been affected. But there's so many different diseases we don't know. Researchers are searching like crazy trying to figure out why are so many oak trees dying. The University of Maryland has a great website. You can Google on it, why are my oak trees dying? And the Maryland has a nice little write-up on the many different diseases that'll give you a heads up on what to look for and what kind of symptoms. But we really don't know why the oak trees are dying. It's unfortunate, but it's happening. It's even surmised that we've probably never seen so many trees at exactly the same diameter. They really think that it was the environmental conditions of 2018, 2019. We had really wet summers. They think the wet conditions are one of the primary concerns for the tree roots. They think a lot of the root hairs and the relationship with the fungus might have caused damage, and that might be why the trees are dying. We're not fully sure, but those are some facts, Master Gardeners. I'm not a pathologist. I don't know it all. Go look it up.